This may just be the largest shipping container home in the world on Airbnb. It is made up of 7 containers, has 5 bedrooms, and it can sleep up to 12 guests total. And we are gonna cover every square inch of it. Let's now go and start the full tour. Welcome to the Huga Box Hop, located in Rockbridge, Ohio. This absolutely massive shipping container home contains a lot of Scandinavian design elements. We're looking at the front exterior of the home right now, and it combines both the slick black paint job with some wood finishing. Now at the back of this container home, you can see these 7 different containers a little more clearly from this angle. You also have a lot of outdoor space, which includes these 4 private balconies shown up by the 4 different mics that you see here in frame. On the ground floor, you also have these gigantic glass window panes, which cannot be missed. This home is made up of 3 40-foot containers and 4 20-foot containers. But that's it for the first part of the exterior, so let's now go and open up this main door to see what the interior has to offer. When you first enter, you'll see the outdoor patio space there on the right. We'll get to that a little later, and the long staircase which leads to the second floor. Let's walk in further, and we'll come first to the kitchen. You have this huge countertop area with 4 stools beneath it. If we walk behind the counter, let's go in now to the kitchen, which is very modern and has every appliance imaginable. First up, you have a high-end fridge and freezer set up with a water dispenser. Further in then, you have your typical coffee maker and hot water heater and a few other items in this countertop space. On the shelves, you then have some more dishes and mugs, and in that picture frame, you have the definition of Huga, which is a Danish term. Further down, you have more cabinets and your beautiful stovetop and oven. There's also a microwave, and then opposite of that, you can find your dishwasher hidden behind here. Last but not least, you also have a large sink. This is a great area to get some work done in. The Wi-Fi was very fast. Let's now venture into the living room area. There's a lot for us to see in this space, like your huge dining table, the couch, and your floating fireplace. But first up for the table, this is one of the largest tables I've ever seen in an Airbnb. You can see up to 10 guests. And then your floating fireplace. I mean, just look how cool this thing looks. Very modern and futuristic, and is surrounded by windows on all sides. Now, if I take the camera and slowly pan up, you can see just how tall this floating fireplace is, but also this beautiful ceiling. You have some more wood finishing up here, some additional lighting, and then 3 skylights to let in a bunch of natural light to this room. Now, if I look in front of your dining table, you have your massive couch. You have 2, if not 3, rows of pillows. It's all insanely comfortable. There's also your coffee table and a bunch of extra blankets, but you could fit the whole family on this couch. One of the coolest features, though, is your huge projector screen. So I pull that down, it takes up all of this space, and you have some great entertainment options in your living room. I'll briefly point out some of the items in this corner. You have this large shelf, and if I open up the door, there's a few things inside here, like information on Louis Poulsen, who is a Danish lighting manufacturer, and some cabin books. To begin to wrap up in the living room, I just have to point out these breathtaking windows one more time. I know what you're thinking, but there are no neighbors nearby. You have complete privacy out here. We'll exit this room through the door on the right, but first up, there is a piano here. Yeah, sorry, it's been a couple years since I played piano. Let's now go through this door on the right to come into bathroom number 1 of 2 here at the Huga. This is actually a handicap accessible bathroom. I've never seen another bathroom like this before at any other Airbnb throughout my travels, so it's nice that you're able to accommodate other types of guests if they have disabilities. You have a nice peach colored sink here though, and some beautiful tiling, then your minimalist looking shower on the other end, which also includes a bench and some more railings. Let's now go right next door to the bathroom and head in through this other white door. And this will take us to the first bedroom here. It is the only bedroom on the ground floor, and about half of the bed is covered head to toe in pillows. It was very comfortable. You also then have your dresser and some extra towels if you pan more to the left. Going even further then, you'll see now from the inside one of those private balconies that we saw earlier. There are four balconies total. And you have these two comfortable white chairs here. You can then gaze out into your backyard. The grass here was really green, just saying. Now back in the kitchen, we're gonna open up this large sliding glass door, and this will take you to your outdoor patio. You actually have another floating fireplace here along with four chairs. And if you look up, part of the roof hangs out. So this area is actually covered in case you have any bad weather. Now I'll take the drone and zoom out a little bit to get more of an overview of this outdoor patio. You actually have over 1,200 square feet of outdoor patio space, so it's quite spacious. You then have more seating options on this end with these plush, white, comfortable cushions. And if you look in the top right, there's a bit of a lens flare because the sun sets directly facing this patio. Last but not least, along this wall, you have a grill. Let's now venture in through this door to see the last area. Hidden back in this space, you have two major outdoor amenities. First up is this gigantic hot tub. You can fit a bunch of guests here. And then next to it, you have this six-person sauna. This all, again, faces the sunset perfectly, and I think fits in really well with the overall Scandinavian theme that we've seen here throughout the tour. Back inside in this main entry hall, we're now gonna walk up this long staircase because we still have the entire second floor left to explore. There are a lot of rooms and doors for us to check out. This is looking to the left. I'm first gonna look over here to the right. That closed door at the end is a closet, so we're now gonna walk through this first door at the far end. This will take us into a bedroom. There are four bedrooms upstairs here on this floor, each with a slightly different theme. This one encompasses more of that beautiful peach color we've seen throughout the home, in addition to some pillows and picture frames. You can also see very clearly still one of those walls has the original container wall. And if we pop on behind here, you have a closet set up with a little shelf, some towels, a mirror, and hangers. We'll now exit this first upstairs bedroom and go into the middle bedroom. This is personally my favorite bedroom on this floor. I really loved all of that wood paneling, how it goes even all the way up top to the ceiling. You have a similar bedding setup though and color scheme. I thought the lighting was really on point in this room. Also, all of these bedrooms have the same closets. Now, still looking down that main hallway to the left, we're gonna go through this far door, and this will take us now into the third bedroom that we visited so far on this floor. The color scheme is different. It's a little more white or cream colored. And yes, there is another closet behind the bed. Now we will round the corner and look down this last section of the same hallway. We're gonna go into the final two rooms of this home now, starting first with another full bathroom that is shared by these bedrooms here upstairs. You have a nice shower there on the right-hand side. I actually really liked all the black tiling in here. I haven't seen a black bathroom like this in quite some time. Now, last but not least, we're gonna walk through this other door, and this will take us into the fifth bedroom. Yes, just to clarify, there are five bedrooms total in this massive container home. This one has more green colored bedding and these really uniquely shaped windows that look out towards the front exterior. There's also a cool lighting fixture up top, and yes, another closet. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.